strategy that Blue Sky Capital has for India. I understand that you've been here for a while, and now you're actively looking at investments.
Yeah. So Ashika, we came. The fund in US has had almost an 8-year history.
Right.
We started on the derivative side, and then started getting into small business buyouts in the US, and then we started growing our VC business. The VC side of the investments have been around for a little more than 3 years now. It started in August of 2015. And about 2 years ago, we came to India. The reason was very crystal clear. There's a macro, at a macro level, this is where the next level of growth is, right? As you know, the US market is getting very competitive for deals. And there's also a lot of stagnancy in terms of, you know, the growth potential. You know, people, where do you come? You obviously come to, you know, places in the emerging markets, right? Right, so we started
also
with India.
The kind of scale that India has.
Yes, exactly, right? I mean, it's a very different scale, and I think there's also a lot of risk capital that is required in the country.
Sure.
There's not enough risk capital here. We saw that, you know, a lot of the segments were underserved or underpenetrated when it came to venture capital. So our premise is very simple. This is where the growth is. There's a demand for risk capital. So, you know, let's evaluate. So we came here about 20 months ago, to be precise, and we made 3 investments in the last 18 months. It's been pretty fast. You know, having 3 investments in 18 months is like a run rate of one per every 6 months. So the first deal we did was a company called SalesPro, which is now by the known by the name of Revlocity. What they do is very simple. There are a lot of tech founders who have very good idea about technology and what it is solving. But, you know, building sales and marketing outreach programs for them is a challenge, right? Because at the end of the day, every startup needs customers. They don't need venture capital, right? So they're focused on that space. New location, Bangalore and Chandigarh. And 2 founders, you know, who have very strong sales background, and they have, you know, scaled this company, little more than 100 people now. You know, the revenue run rate has grown significantly since we invested. So that was the first investment. The second investment we made was in a hospitality tech company called Backpacker Panda. Very simple, the rationale for investing was very simple. You look at the entire infrastructure, the hotels, everything, they're all focused on 3, 4 and 5 stars, right? There are players like Oyo in the budget segment, but there's literally nobody who's focused on the millennial travels. You know, the backpackers who travel on a certain
budget,
right? We like the founders.
The hostel concept.
Yes, right. And what they've done is very beautiful. They're using a lot of tech, okay? So they have an OTA side to it. And they also have built an entire operations management. So it's, think of it like an ERP for hospitality,
sure,
but only focused on hostels, right?
Sure.
Because there's no concept of a key there. There's a concept of a bed.
Right?
I mean, their inventory, pricing, everything is very different from a typical hospitality player.
It's also coming from your own home country, US, because US is very developed in this.
Yes. So the founder there, you know, learned about this concept during his education in Canada and Germany. So he brought it. Now, if you look at their own self-managed properties, I think they're, I don't remember the exact number, they're between 12 and 14, between franchisee and their own. And the OTA side, they're more than 60, I mean, world over, right? Growing very fast. So, you know, they are pivoting to, or have already pivoted very successfully towards being an OTA for the backpacking industry, right? So that's the second investment we made. The third investment we made was a seed round. Yeah, not more than 6 months ago. The company is called Medimetry. They're in the telemedicine public health space. So if you look at the Indian healthcare system, there is the tertiary care, which is large hospitals. It gets choked, okay? So everything from a general practitioner where you have a throat infection to a fever to a heart surgery actually happens at a tertiary, right? That entire primary healthcare channel is completely missing, right? And what these guys have done is they've said in the semi-rural side, we will focus on that and we will leverage the primary healthcare to become a low cost marketing engine for insurance and pharma, because they have not been able to penetrate into the semi-urban areas at all, and that infrastructure is completely missing.
Fair enough, and also there's a lot of potential there.
Yeah, so you know they've got into that. You know, if you look at the telemedicine space, the problem with telemedicine space is how do you get customers to come online?
Mm-hmm.
So what we've done is we changed the entire model. So the aggregation and connect with the doctor is happening in physical through camps. Then you know we are working towards prototypes of mobile hospitals. These are not ambulances; these are hospitals.
Okay,
we're building. You know, we're going to raise the next round of funding is actually be focused on that. So what happens
coastal
is
semi-urban.
Yes, it's a, you know, if you look at it by some estimates, it's like a 200 million population, right? And interestingly, what we have figured out as we have penetrated those, you know, we have micro-scaled it in Haryana, especially Faridabad, we have a very good coverage there. One thing we figured out, that people are willing to pay for insurance and pharmacy, but they don't want to pay for doctor consulting. Okay, so what we did was, instead of focusing on the consulting fee, we decided that we'll become a supply chain.
Tell me, what is it that you find most exciting in the Indian space? Of course, I understood the idea about tapping into the middle class, semi-urban,
and rural
market also eventually.
Yes.
But what is it that you find most exciting in this ecosystem for technology for India? Of course, India is just starting.
Yeah, I think one is that the quality of startups in India, it's like the second or third largest biggest ecosystem now, right? Look at the quality of your conference. I mean, it's packed, right? So I think there's an aspirational lot. There are people who, you know, want to become entrepreneurs are not exactly interested in a lot of jobs, right? While all this is there, there's an entrepreneurial spirit, there's an opportunity. The biggest missing piece there has been the lack of capital, risk capital,
right?
I mean, you need capital to grow. So I think that is also now improving. So I'm pretty excited about, you know, although my background is all technology advisory, I think I'm getting pretty excited about the healthcare space. I think there are a lot of interesting solutions which are needed for India at the price point where it can be affordable, right? So Medimetry only focuses on chronic diseases as an example. But you know, how many of these healthcare providers can actually hire DM, MD doctors, right? I mean, we were focused on diabetes, is a major area of focus on Medimetry. I mean, by some statistic, there are 2,500 DM doctors in endocrinology. So, you know, even if you build the reach, there's not enough medical talent available. And this is not something you can solve as a problem overnight. So we have turned the problem upside down. We're building a disease management platform, which is tech, where, you know, the doctors are getting trained on what the clinical protocols are for treating it. So we can now actually take a good MBBS doctor, and while he does not have capability to treat diabetes, we are training him to understand what diabetes as a disease, how it progresses, right? So he at least has the clinical exposure there.
And what about the companies that are looking for investment from Blue Sky?
Yeah.
I mean, not many people understand the concept of hedge funds today. Today it's all VC, VC, VC.
Yeah.
But in your ecosystem, I think you have a lot more to provide. If a company comes to you for investments, how do you pivot them?
So our evaluation is very focused on the promoter. Okay. Our belief is very simple. If the promoter is good, the business will be, good on its own. Right? He'll have the necessary skills to pivot. He'll have the necessary skills to build unit economics and build the business on a profitable basis.
I see.
Right? So the focus is all on promoters. Typically, we observe companies anywhere between 6 months to 18 months.